Welcome for this lecture. Today we are going to discuss module 5, that is two port network. So two port network means for the network will be having two inputs and will be having two outputs, where usually we have seen one input to be given to the system and output. So in this case, two port networks will be having two inputs and two outputs. For example of this one, we have seen a transformers and a transmission lines. Why we have to study this two port networks is we may apply an input signal to the system from one port, and output we can obtain from the signal of a other port. Okay, then these parameters, so when we say two port networks, and by this we are going to study two port parameters of different types. Okay, those parameters we are going to study. So actually, these parameters of a two port network completely describes its behaviors in terms of voltage and currents at each port. And then, so thus knowing the parameters of a two port network permits us to describe its operation when it connected to a large network. Two port networks are also important in modeling electronic devices and system components. So for example, in electronics, so we are going to use this two port networks are employed to model transistors and op amps. And other examples of electrical components, especially in electrical components, this can be used to model by two port networks are transformers, and we are going to use for transmission lines. Okay, there are actually four main types of two port net parameters we have. Four types. First one is impedance parameters. Second one is admittance parameters, and then third one is ABCD parameters, and fourth one is hybrid parameters, that is also called as H parameters. Among these, we are going to discuss only three, that is impedance, admittance, and ABCD parameters. Let's see one by one. So as we have said, types of two port parameters are of impedance parameters. This is also called as open circuit impedance parameter. Let's see why we call this as open circuit impedance parameters. And second one is admittance parameters. This is also called as short circuit admittance parameters, or simply we can say Y parameter. This is also called as simply Z parameters. And then third one is transmission parameters, is also called as ABCD parameters. Simply we can call it as T parameters. Okay. Now we'll discuss one by one. So for this to remember each, so we have certain formulas to remember each one. So for impedance, for admittance and transmissions, if you remember all these formulas, easily we can apply for the different type of numericals. Let's say first one, that is impedance parameters. This is a two port network. Okay, this is a two port network which has two inputs and two outputs. So this is your I1 current, and this side is I2 current, V1 and V2. Okay, this is your two port linear network. Okay, this is your two port linear network. Now we have to define this two port network in terms of impedances. So how we are going to define this as, so we are using superposition theorem to represent, to write the equations for input and output voltages. Okay, let's see when you applied input voltages and output voltages by using a superposition theorem, we can write the equations like this, or else you can remember these equations. So V1 equal to Z1 I1 plus Z1 2 I2, and this is the first equation. And the second is V2 equal to, when V1 you are writing, that time V2 is kept open. Okay, means we are not going to consider that, sorry. V2 we are not going to consider. Similarly, when you are writing with respect to V2, V1 should not be considered. Therefore, V2 will be equal to Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. We can remember these two equations. Impedance parameters, this is a two-port network, and these two are the equations of it. V1 equal to Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2. V2 equal to Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. So, based on these two, we are going to take and derive the equations for what is the Z11 value, what is Z12, Z21 and Z22. That is impedance parameters here. Okay, what is the value of Z11? What is the formula of Z11? What is the formula of Z12? We are going to find out by using these two equations. Let's see. Those two equations we are going to write in the form of matrix form. That is, see, this is the V1 and V2 equal to Z11 I1, Z12 I2. This is Z21 I1, Z22 I2. So here we are going to write Z11, Z12, Z21 and Z22 into I1 and I2. So like this we can express this one in the form of matrix. Once we have written this, we can define the Z parameters by using that formula. That was which formula we had? V1 equal to I11 Z, sorry, let's see this equation. V1 equal to Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2. Let's take only this equation and we'll write what is the formula for Z11. What is Z11? Z11 will be equal to, okay. So that time what we have to do is let's make I2 equal to 0 to get Z11 value. That is I2, when I2 is becomes 0, okay. When I2 is 0, then what will be this? This term will be 0. That time V11 will be equal to Z11 into I1. Therefore, Z11 will be equal to V1 divided by I1. Okay, like this. That is Z11 equal to, it is nothing but V1 divided by I1 when it is true, when I2 we made equal to 0, it is equal to 0. Okay, similarly, where Z12 equal to, now what we have to do? I1 we have to make equal to 0. That time, so Z12 will be equal to what? Only this term and this term will be present. Z12 equal to V1 divided by I2. When it is true when I1 equal to 0. Okay, similarly, like this, you can write Z21, that time I2 can be make 0. And then when you are finding out Z22, that time you make I1 equal to 0. So from that we have got Z11 equal to V1 by I1 when I2 equal to 0, Z12 equal to V1 by I2 when I1 equal to 0, Z21 equal to V2 by I1 when I2 equal to 0. So Z22 is V2 divided by I2 when I1 equal to 0. These formulas we have to remember, else we have to remember these two equations. From these two equations, easily we can find out what is Z11 by making I2 equal to 0. Other terms, which term you are going to find out? Other term should be 0. Okay, this is about Z parameters or impedance parameters. Observe in this case, what do you mean by I2 equal to 0, I1 equal to 0? We say it is nothing but a current equal to 0. When in the circuit current equal to 0? When the circuit is open circuit, okay, when the circuit is open, that time current will be equal to 0. So when we are taking this Z11 value, when I2 equal to 0 means secondary side of the output side of the circuit should be kept open. So to get this Z11, similarly to get a Z12, I1, that is input side circuit should be kept open. We will get V1 by I2. Therefore, I1 equal to 0, I2 equal to 0. So this represents current, a circuit is open. Therefore, all these preceding equations, we can say since we have kept I1 and I2 equal to 0 in the equivalent open circuit, it represents. Therefore, the Z parameters are also called as, since we are keeping I1 and I2 as zeros, in terms of meaning of this one is keeping the circuit input and output side are kept open. Therefore, the Z parameters are also called as open circuit impedance parameters, because we are keeping the circuits open. Whenever we require Z11, we will keeping output side circuit as open, and input side we are keeping open circuit when we require output impedance. Therefore, this is called as open circuit impedance parameter. In this case, this Z11 is this can be said as open circuit input impedance. Okay, because it is Z11, it will be there at this side. Okay, so therefore it will be what? Z11 is defined as the open circuit input impedance. And similarly, your Z22 is open circuit output impedance. Z12 and Z21 are called as this. Z12 and Z21 are called as open circuit transfer impedances. Okay, then if Z12 equal to Z21, if Z12 is equal to Z21, then the network is said to be reciprocal network. Okay, and if all the impedances are if all the Z parameters are identical, then it is called as a symmetrical network. When we say that symmetrical network, we can define this as, okay, when we say this is a symmetrical network, when all the Z parameters are same. Okay, so this is about impedance parameters. Now we'll discuss the other parameters, that is admittance parameters. It is also called as Y parameter. It's also called as short circuit admittance parameter. So let's consider the network. This is a two port linear network which has two ports, means two inputs and two outputs. Current I1 is entering here, I2 here is V1 and V2. So two port network remains same. Now, so by the definition of this, you can take a superposition theorem. By applying superposition theorem for the current, you can write these two equations. So you have to remember these two equations. For this network, let's define I1 equal to, I1 will be defined as Y11 into V1 plus Y12 into V2. Similarly, I2 equal to Y21 V1 plus Y22 V2. So now these two equations, we have to represent this one in the matrix form. Okay, that is nothing but I1 I2 equal to, so here it comes Y11, Y12, Y21, Y22 and into V1 and V2. So this is your matrix form. And then we have to find out what is the value of Y11, Y12, Y21 and Y22. In the same way, to calculate this, we have to make V1 equal to 0 and V2 equal to 0s. Let's see. So these two equations we have expressed in terms of matrix form. And then Y parameters we need to calculate. These two are the equations of main. I1 equal to Y11 V1 plus Y12 V2. And here I2 equal to Y21 V1 plus Y22 V2. From this, let's calculate what is Y11. Y11 will be equal to, calculate Y11, what we have to do is V2 equal to 0 we have to take. Y12 equal to 0? No, because we are finding out that. So it is a variable for us. V2 is a voltage that you can make it to 0. So when this term is 0, I1 equal to Y11 V1. Therefore, Y11 will be equal to I1 divided by V1 when V2 equal to 0. This is Y11. Similarly, in this equation only, we are going to take what is Y12. What is Y12? That time, V1 should be equal to 0. Y12 equal to what? I1 divided by V2 when V1 equal to 0. Right? Similarly, from this second equation, we'll find out what is Y1, Y21. Y21 is nothing but I2 divided by V1 when this term is 0. That is V2 equal to 0. Similarly, we'll find out what is Y22. That is Y22 equal to, Y22 is nothing but I2 divided by V2 when V1 is equal to 0. Okay, so same those things we have found it out. What in this equations, what do you mean by this V1 equal to 0, V2 equal to 0? Meaning of this is voltage equal to 0. When we say voltage is equal to 0, when the circuit is short circuited. Okay, when the circuit is shorted, that time voltage will be equal to 0. Whenever you want Y11, that time V2 means secondary side, that is output side circuit should be short circuited, taki we get V2 equal to 0. Similarly, when you want Y12 or Y22, so for that what we have to do, V1 equal to 0. What do you mean by V1? Input side voltage you have to make it equal to 0. Means input side you have to take as a short circuit. Okay. Then in this, once we have calculated all these values, what we can do is Y12 is nothing but a short circuit transfer admittance. Y22 is short circuit output admittance. Okay. Collectively, the Y parameters are referred to as a short circuit admittance parameters. Why we are calling this as short circuit admittance parameters? Because we are taking V1 and V2s are 0. Means for the one value, we are making other circuit equal to 0. Means voltage we are making to 0. It means we are shorting out. Okay. So then we'll discuss the last parameters, that is transmission parameters. It's also called as ABCD parameters, or also it is called as simply T parameters. Okay, same network is remains the same, that is I1 is entering, I2 is entering, here it is I1, I2, but what I2 we are going to consider here is minus I2. Let's define the transmission parameters. These are the definition for transmission parameters. We supposed to remember this. Okay, that is V1 equal to A into V2 minus B into I2. Okay, that's what we are going to take it as minus I2, right? V1 equal to A V2 minus B I2. I1 equal to C V2 minus D I2. These two equations we have to remember. Now we are familiar with this to express in matrix form, that is V1 I1 equal to, then it will be A, B, C, D, and then into there will be V2 minus I2. Okay, so this is a matrix form representation of this. V1 I1 equal to A, B, C, D into V2 minus I2. Okay, this is the matrix representation. Let's calculate its ABCD parameters. That is, to calculate A, then what we have to do, I2 should be equal to 0. Then make I2 equal to 0, your equation will be V1 equal to A into V2, where I2 equal to 0. Therefore, A will be equal to V1 divided by V2, when I2 equal to 0. Similarly, B will be equal to, when you are finding out B equal to, so then what that time V2 should be 0. That V2, you have to make it equal to 0. Then what is the B? B will be equal to V1 divided by minus I2. Okay. So here you can observe, here this is not an open and short circuit. It is a combination of this. See, when you are going to calculate A value, that time I2 should be made 0. That is, secondary circuit should be kept open. When you are calculating B value, secondary side voltage should be, means secondary circuit should be short circuited. Similarly, to calculate C value, C is equal to, it should be I1 divided by V2, when other term should be 0. When we can, how we can do it? I2 equal to 0. What do you mean by I2 equal to 0? Secondary side current should, I mean secondary side circuit should be kept open. Similarly, D will be equal to, D is equal to I1, that is this I1 divided by minus I2, when V2 equal to 0. This is regarding secondary circuit. One side you have, secondary side, one time you have to keep that open circuit, another time you have to keep for the short circuit to get C and D, as well as A and B. Okay. So these are the values of A, B, C, D. These are the ABCD parameters, its equations. So observe, you are keeping secondary side circuit is open, that is I2 equal to 0, and you are making secondary side voltage equal to 0, that is short circuit. When you are keeping that circuit open, you can find out A and C. When your circuit is short circuited, you can calculate B and D. Okay. Now, when the two port networks does not contain any dependent sources, then the following relation holds good for transmission parameters, that is AD minus BC equal to 1. That is A parameter into D parameter minus B parameter into C parameter will be equal to 1. This is valid only for reciprocal network. Okay.